Hi, I'm Pastor Goodman, and this is the Largely Catechized Life. We are changing up the format a little bit here, if for no other reason than I really hate that. How many Lutherans does it take to change a light bulb joke?
Change.
I would have edited that part out. We are live now talking about the Apostles' Creed, which is important because, well, if you want to know who your God is, you got to look to what he does. This is something that even our critics understand. They recognize this. And so the problem is they only see the first article of the creed, the creation, the God, the Father working in this world part. And, well, sometimes that doesn't look great. You know who God is based on what he does. Well, he's the one who does awful, awful things. He's the one who lets there be cancer and suffering and natural disaster and all kinds of evils and atrocities and death. And you can just say that he allowed it. But the thing is, if you're going to confess in the meaning of the first article that God the Father defends me from all harm and danger, well, when you're in harm and danger, he's culpable. See, the creed helps us to look to more than just what's right in front of us. And that's important because, well, when I stub my toe, all I can see is my toe and the coffee table. In the midst of pain, I'm not going to be able to see anything beyond that. There is more to creation than my toe and the coffee table, but at that moment, I will not see a single other thing. And in the same way, when all kinds of things are going wrong in this world, it is awful hard to look past this world. But the creed helps us see that there is more going on here. Luther helps us understand it. He writes, "But that it may be most easily and clearly understood, as it is to be taught to children, we shall briefly sum up the entire creed in three chief articles. According to the three persons of the Godhead, to whom everything that we believe is related. So that the first article of God the Father explains creation, the second article of God the Son, redemption, and the third of the Holy Spirit, sanctification." See, Luther breaks down the creed very simply. He does it for children. It's not the fullest understanding of how our triune God operates, because we also recognize that it's more than just God the Father who had to do with creation. The Holy Spirit hovered over the face of the deep. Colossians 1:16 says, "For by Jesus all things were created in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible," and in the second and third articles of the creed too. It's not just Jesus that had to do with the redemption. It's not that Jesus went rogue against the Father and the Holy Spirit to save you. It's not that the Holy Spirit is operating independently. In fact, each person of the Trinity is not operating independently of one another with their own separate goals. They work collectively for a common good. This is laid out not so that we can only look to one person of the Trinity for one thing, but so that we can see all three persons of the Trinity working together for you. Luther closes the creed in this way. "We could never attain to the knowledge of the grace and favor of the Father except through the Lord Christ, who is a mirror of the eternal heart, outside of whom we see nothing but an angry and terrible judge. But of Christ, we could know nothing either, unless it had been revealed by the Holy Ghost." You understand who the Father is in relation to the Son. You understand who the Son is in relation to the Holy Spirit. You want to know who God is, you look to what he does, not to divorce each person from certain actions, but to see them all working together for good. And there we can actually start to look at this world inside of something bigger, that even when terrible things are happening inside of this creation in the first article of the creed, the second article of the creed tells us that God the Son is put right in the middle of that suffering and death for you upon a cross, not only to bear it himself, but to bear it for you, to bring you through suffering and unto the glories of the resurrection. The Holy Spirit in the third article in your sanctification is tied intimately to your justification. Inside of all of these things, there is more going on than meets the eye. There is more than just your toe and the coffee table in this world. And so, yes, we ascribe one work to the Father in creation, another to the Son in redemption, another to the Spirit in sanctification, not so that we can divorce the Father from the Son, from the Holy Spirit, but so that we can see the connection between creation and redemption and sanctification, so that we can see all three persons of the Trinity in works that are intimately connected for you and for your good. And there, even in the midst of things that we cannot understand, we can see more going on and have some peace.